Coarse fishing is a fantastic sport that all the family can enjoy. However, the perceived cost can sometimes put people off a bit. In this video, we're going to show you how you can still enjoy coarse fishing even on a limited budget. Before you do go fishing, there's something that you're going to need. And unfortunately, this is something that you can't scrimp and save on, and that's a rod license. If you're over 16, you're going to need a full license to fish anywhere in the UK, ranging from the most public stretches of river to the most private estate lakes. If you do get caught fishing without a license, you'll almost certainly face a court appearance and a hefty fine, so really, it's not worth it. And aside from that, the money that you do spend on a rod licence goes back into the development of angling in the UK, so if you don't buy one, you are cheating the system.
At the time of posting this video in July 2016, current rod licence rules for coarse fish and non-migratory trout state that anglers under 12 do not require a licence. Anglers aged 12 to 16 require a junior licence, which costs £5. Anglers over 16 require a full licence, which costs £27. Anglers over 65 or disabled anglers can buy an annual concessionary licence for £18. All annual licences currently expire on March 31st, 2017. Instead of buying an annual licence, you can buy a temporary licence, either for 1 day or 8 days. The 1 day option costs £3.75 and the 8 day costs £10. All of the above licences cover you to fish with two rods only. If you want to fish with three rods, you must purchase an additional licence. In 2017, there are proposals to overhaul the rod licence pricing structure, which include the abolition of the junior licence and the introduction of a three-rod licence. For a full rundown of these proposals, and to keep yourself updated on when they will be implemented, please visit the Environment Agency's website. Finally, remember that the post office is the only legitimate source to buy your license from. This can be done in person over the counter, over the telephone, or via the post office website.
One of the most contentious issues in coarse fishing is the perceived cost of equipment. But even if you buy the most expensive equipment, it doesn't necessarily guarantee that you're going to catch the most or the biggest fish. In the same way that if you buy the most expensive car, it's not going to necessarily make you a better driver. So, what we're going to show you now is how you can spend minimal money and still catch plenty of fish.
Although you can find a lot of cheap equipment online, there's no substitute for going to your local tackle shop and actually trying out the gear for yourself. Your local tackle dealer will be able to advise you on the best equipment for your budget, and even if you have seen cheaper deals online, most tackle shops will often match these prices. Buying a float fishing setup from a tackle shop couldn't be simpler, and this is a versatile outfit that you can take anywhere in the UK to do some coarse fishing with. For more detailed instructions on how to use a float setup, check out our video about float fishing on this channel.
Okay, in this section we're going to talk about bait, and bait can sometimes be quite a contentious issue anyway, as there's often the misinformed view that the most expensive bait is going to be the best. But I'm going to run through now some of the best baits that cost the least money. Well, first up, it's the humble maggot, probably one of the best baits you can ever use. On average, a pint of maggots will cost you about £3 from your local tackle shop, and that's more than adequate for a day's fishing. It's not just small fish that will take maggots either, right from the smallest minnow up to the biggest carp. There's very few coarse fish in Britain that won't take a maggot. In short, they're probably one of the best baits you can ever use. Next up, sweet corn. I don't know how many British record carp have been caught on sweet corn. It really is a fantastic bait, and it's not just carp that like it. Roach like it, bream like it, tench. What I like to do is to go to my local supermarket and buy a large bag of frozen sweet corn and then separate that out into smaller bags, which can then be used for a session. So really about this much sweet corn, probably around 1/4 of a kilo, is more than adequate for a day's fishing. Then we have another old favourite, which is the humble old loaf of bread. Bread, another excellent bait. It can be presented in many different ways. It can be presented using a bread punch, as bread flake on the hook. You can use the crust part, and the crust part tends to float really well, which can make it a devastating bait on the surface for carp. Then finally, we have meat. There are various different types of meat you can use. There's this type, which is like a spicy sausage type, which is very durable. It's very appealing to big fish like carp, tench and bream. And then you've got luncheon meat as well. It's a very versatile kind of bait, but just make sure that the fishery that you're fishing at does actually allow meat, as some don't. So, you've got your license, you've got your equipment, and you've got your bait. The next question is, where are you going to go fishing? Well, in this section, we're going to take you through the various options that are open to you, even if you are fishing on a budget. Chances are, no matter where you live in the UK, you live near a park lake. And park lakes are a fantastic place to go fishing, particularly if you're on a budget, because they're not particularly expensive to fish. The one I'm at now, which is right in the town centre, only costs £4.50 to fish on a day ticket for adults. And it's also got membership options where you can buy a ticket for the whole year and have unlimited fishing for relatively little cost. Not only that, but park lakes offer fantastic mixed fishing, as you're about to see on this particular venue. So, in just an hour's fishing, this is a selection of the sort of great fish you can catch at a park lake. We've got all sorts here. We've got roach, we've got rudd, we've got bream, we've got perch. Excellent fishing in a park lake for only £4 a day ticket. If the hustle and bustle of a park lake isn't for you, then there's still plenty of options. Take commercial fisheries or day ticket waters, for example. In particular, this one that I'm fishing now, they have quite high stock levels in terms of the fish that they have in there. So 9 times out of 10, you're always going to have a good day's fishing. And if you're on a budget, that is important to get your money's worth. Well, you don't always need the most expensive tackle or the most expensive bait to catch big fish. Just using exactly the same float tactics, with a bit of sweet corn, fishing in the margins down here at this day ticket fishery. And hooked a nice carp, so hopefully we'll be able to have a look at it in a minute. The other good thing about using this sort of tackle to target all sizes of fish is that you never quite know what you're going to catch next, and when you do hook something substantial like I have now, it doesn't half give you a real good run for your money. Feel every single lunge that the fish is making. It makes the fight really exciting. Here he comes. Yes, he's in the net. Get in there. Well, here we go. This is the fish that gave me that epic battle just now. On the float setup. It's not a massive carp, but it's certainly a decent size, under 10 pounds, and a brilliant sport just on float tackle. There we go. Another option to you venue-wise is to join your local angling club. The fees to join on an annual basis don't tend to be that expensive, and you'll often get a range of different venues that you can fish. This particular angling club that I've joined entitles me to fish 4 different waters, all with a great range of species, right from the smallest silverfish up to carp and catfish of specimen size. So if you are on a budget, it's definitely worth having a look at your local angling club and see what the options are. Right, well, here's the sort of fish you can catch if you join an angling club. They've got great stocks, and these are the sort of stamp of fish you can catch for not a lot of money, so it's definitely well worth it. Let's get this one back and see if we can get another. Well, hopefully in this video you've picked up some useful information that'll enable you to get out and do some coarse fishing, even if you are on a limited budget.